Spider-Man number 15 by Brian Michael Bendis and Szymon Kudranski. After their wild dimension-hopping adventure, Jefferson and his son Miles, aka Spider-Man, make a phone call to his mom, but she doesn't answer. He leaves a message and they go for dinner. Jefferson asks Miles about his Spider-Girl love interest, and they share a quick father-son talk before Bendis has to throw an SJW jab in, thinking Miles was in love with Ganke. They take off, planning to sneak back into their respective homes, keeping Rio in the dark. Jefferson quietly enters the house and finds his wife sitting in the living room, asking if Miles is with them. They hear a noise in his bedroom, and she calls out to him, ordering him to come out now. He walks in, and she shows him a formula for his web fluid she found. She demands answers. Her husband and son mysteriously disappear, and in addition to the fluid, she finds a mystery phone of her husband's. He tells her he's working for S.H.I.E.L.D. again. She asks why, and he says it was because he was worried about Miles. She looks at her son, and he removes his shirt. Clinging to the ceiling, he reveals to her that he's Spider-Man. She asks how long this has been going on, and he tells her a couple years. Enraged, she accuses Jefferson of lying to her all this time. Miles explains to her that he kept it from her because anyone who knows is in danger. He apologizes, and Jefferson tells her not to go to her mother with this info. She tells him that he can no longer make these demands. She's just going to tell everybody he cheated on her, which is about all the same. Meanwhile, back at the dorm, Miles listens in as Ganke watches his YouTube videos trolling Spidey. Disgusted, he wakes up just as Fabio Medina stops in with an army of pizzas left over from a social. They discuss the events that just took place, which essentially ties in everything from a few issues back. A page later, a nefarious figure sits talking with his henchmen about there being too many superheroes ruining their plans. He especially refers to Spider-Man. And back at Jefferson's apartment, this super mysterious cell phone rings. A S.H.I.E.L.D. operative informs him that Maria Hill is no longer with the organization, and all of her operations are suspended. The phone disintegrates, and with that, he's no longer a secret agent. The issue concludes with Danica, the viral YouTube spider hater, walking down the halls of the school. There, Ganke stops to say hello, and this storyline is over. You know, I've been a fan of Brian Michael Bendis for a long time. The only irritating thing with him is that you better plan on doing a lot of reading with him. He's got to be one of the most banal and long-winded writers out there. I understand his employment with Guardians of the Galaxy is coming to an end. I really wouldn't mind seeing somebody take over Miles Morales' destiny for a while as well. For now, though, I guess we're stuck with him. I give this one a 7 out of 10. If you like this video, there's hundreds more like it, spanning several current and classic story arcs. Click the boxes here for more playlists. This video is also accompanied by my blog at nerdiestkidyouknow.blogspot.com or nerdiestkidyouknow.com. You can also follow links to my Facebook, Instagram, or Twitter, as well as a link to this very issue for sale in my eBay store by clicking below. For the Nerdiest Kid You Know, I'm Sam Torito. Thanks for watching.